The Korean government has rolled out a 10-year plan to combine the best of Korea's traditional crafts and relics with the latest cutting-edge technology, creating a brand new market of unique high-tech products. In our news feature tonight, Oh Soo-young shows us a few of these new products, some of which are currently under development.
Imagine 3D printing a traditional Korean house or hanok that's full-sized and livable, complete with authentic features. That's what a research team at the Korea Institute for Science and Technology aims to do within 5 years, as part of a new Korean government initiative to recreate traditional relics with state-of-art technology. The team is repurposing traditional construction materials like granite and clay as 3D printing filaments, and using pinewood extract as a natural adhesive. It won't just apply to quaint Korean-style housing. These developments will contribute to 3D printing advancements in the global architectural industry, especially when it comes to constructing sustainable and eco-friendly buildings.
Some hanoks are hundreds of years old, but concrete apartment buildings have to be rebuilt every 30 to 40 years. They're sturdy but inconsistent. In terms of sustainability, hanok materials have been successfully tested and they're harmless to the body. And all over the world, many have been developing 3D printing techniques for construction. But until now, there was a lack of research in eco-friendly materials, and there were no eco-friendly adhesives that were strong enough like ours. So we see huge potential in the architectural sector.
In the heart of Seoul, a traditional swordcraft expert is working with top scientists to reintroduce a steel-making technique that can be traced back to the 2nd and 3rd centuries. The multi-layer structuring technique was used in well-known relics like the ring pommel sword, featuring more than 4,000 layers.
In the past, cutting and folding the iron ore over and over pushed out the impurities and created durability. Even now, the process still helps increase the strength of the steel. It's like how paper won't rip as easily if you fold it many times.
While this technology was acquired by Japan around the 6th century and sparked a flourishing culture of craftsmanship, Korea's own steelmaking culture came to an end when the country was colonized by Japan. The team hopes to revive this lost heritage and apply it to mass market items, beginning with high-quality kitchen knives and golf clubs.
We will apply our ancestors' refined structuring technology of folding steel to make products of equal or better quality to those made by industry leaders. Ours will be made traditionally, carrying a unique story.
This lacquer varnish company has also modernized an age-old handicraft, and its eco-friendly paints have already been successfully mass-marketed. Natural lacquer extracted from pine trees has for centuries garnished traditional Korean houses, furniture and household ornaments, with thin but vibrant coats of color and a high luster finish. The substance was traditionally applied by artisans, as it requires complicated techniques to mix the paste, and up to a week to dry completely. But now, anyone can easily use this lacquer to turn everyday items into works of art. The company has re-engineered the chemical components in lacquer to create a ready-made varnish that dries in a couple of hours like ordinary paint. It has also made the paint eco-friendly by removing harmful substances.
We refine the main chemical component, urushiol, and develop various hardening methods. The lacquer can be used in that state or blended with other varnishes for variation. We reduce the time it takes to dry, so it's easy to use, even by people with allergies.
Blending past and present to enhance modern technology, the Korean government aims to develop 20 fusion products by the year 2025. It's a market worth $1.2 billion that's expected to generate some 2,700 jobs. Oh Soo-young, Arirang News.